Guys, I am about ready to go and pick up my new project. The owner is pretty cool, so very, very interesting. It's the bike mostly in parts, and it's pretty interesting. Like, I can't wait to get it home and start cleaning it up.
It's from 1985, and you can tell it needs quite a bit of work, so this is going to be a project. I don't even know if I can get this to work, but hopefully I will. It's from 1985. The parts are kind of scarce these days. The previous owner did try and do a lot of stuff, so he put on a lot of new parts. The first thing I'm gonna do is just clean this bike. Hopefully I can get this to crank. The carbs are over there. Old school dash there. It only has 3,000 miles, which is kind of rare. I mean, it's kind of interesting. The engines on these bikes are very reliable. Front plastic, and here's the seat. You have a bunch of parts, mirrors, just plastics everywhere. This, I believe, is the carb, very important issue. Here's a new belt, we're going to be putting that on. Things are more of a labor of love than anything else. It's not like I'll be able to sell these for very much after I fix them. But I am curious about these 85s. It's amazing what just a little bit of a clean will do. Oh, man, it's just so filthy. It's got quite a bit of rust. We'll have to kind of dig through, but I'm going to clean the outside. First, you have a new belt. Airbox cover. This is nice. This is a SAE plug. We got a pipe, a air filter, floats for the carburetor, another Honda part. We have some tubes, gasket sealant, gas cap. I think it's like the fuel line. Some oil. This is 1040. We have another mirror, another mirror, grab rail. This is the carburetor. So we put it all in baggies. Fuel lines, this is a right side crankcase. We have plenty of work ahead of us. And you know, one thing interesting about this is that I noticed there's no left rear brake lever on this. And I was looking around, okay, maybe the previous owner dropped it, but that doesn't seem to be a way of installing one. So the rear brake on this used the rear brake, and it's kind of interesting. The mechanism for the brake is right here, and you can see the line going to the rear. Here we go, here's the carb. Looks like just a tube that's pinched. I have no idea. As these parts are rather expensive, we have this float, the diaphragm. We have that. Now this is the top part of the carb needle, Do is kind of just put it all back, eject here. The one benefit of having this old bike, this Elite, is that at least you only have to deal with one carb very carefully back top like this. You know, kind of hold it, make sure that it's on there. This Phillips, it's a very like distinct, just make sure you get the exact. I remember that the previous owner ordered, there we go, I don't even know which one I just picked up, but it comes with its own rod, old and new. In here, there's a little direction for it. The new rod, I'm just gonna thread it on there. Just gonna put it this way. And now, like that. And there's, and it should fit flush. Over here, this is where the carb enricher is. There's the hole, kind of slide it in. Well, it's a jet, it goes right in here. That way we need the various hoses. Turn goes like this, so they don't tighten this too much. Give it like one more turn. And it might take a few weeks. So now that we have that off, I've never done this. Like, this is very interesting. I'll clean all that. Fresh new belt. Never changed the belt on a scooter. I never had to. For scooters, it's kind of like the shaft. You don't have to do much. It's very clean. But I don't think I need to do anything with this. It's a while. All right, so I got the belt on here, and the trick, you actually don't even need to remove this. I saw a YouTube video, and basically you can pinch this in such a way that you can get it on without getting that bolt. But you need an impact wrench to get that bolt, unfortunately. But what you have to do to kind of squeeze it over here, I've never installed one of these because it's a little confusing. This part over here, look, it's got teeth, so I thought, oh, this thing needs to go on the teeth part, but it goes on the flat part. So I haven't never changed the belt on a scooter, so that was kind of like a little bit of a learning process. But I did get it on. The new belt is on. The way to get it on is to kind of squeeze this in and loosen it. So if you can get a lot of this, you can actually kind of squeeze the belt off of the bike. It's that easy. So that's how you get it on. It's kind of loose. And then as you're moving, there we go, it tightens up. The cover is interesting because I thought that this gasket was broken, but that's how it is. This is just this dust seal. And now, two bolts go right in here. We're getting somewhere with this bike. You know, I haven't tried starting it. I'm actually a little afraid of starting it. I am waiting for some bolts. This tank is rusted from the inside. The rust here is kind of what the rust is on the inside. Here, we're gonna put a cork on here. So I don't know if you're able to see the rust. This is the, of course, the outside, but on the inside, it does have all sorts of rust in there. You're also gonna need a bunch of nails like this, and you're gonna drop them in the gas tank. Okay, just white vinegar. So the milky substance here is basically the WD-40 mixing with the tank all cleaned up. This is the sensor for the fuel gauge. This is the gasket that goes in the fuel sender. I'm gonna grab the plate and I'm pushing down. That's it. So that's where the fuel comes out. This is the bottom of the tank. Fuel strainer goes directly onto here. Look at this. This is the last piece. The fuel sender plug does go into here. So I was wondering where this little tube goes. And it's on the carburetor. It doesn't connect to anything other than the carburetor. I think it's that. So we're gonna take a piece of brand new hose. We're gonna cut it right about here like a U. It's kind of good to renew all of this stuff. And this line is the enricher. I believe this is not stock. It's a little petcock thing, which is a good idea. Here's the throttle cable.
The real first West Coast guy.
So now let's just get the clip like this. Slice it in here. Unfortunately, this is the wrong terminal. So, all right, guys, I have the battery in. Let's turn the key and see if we have light. Turned, and there is light. High beam. Yep. I'm not gonna crank it just yet because I need to get some gas. I also have the petcock off. We're gonna crank this thing for the first time. Okay. All right. Push the brake. Nothing. I think it's just this. Yeah, nothing. The safety is here. You actually have to hold the rear brake like this, but I think I'm having an issue with the battery. So if I do this, push it down. So we do hear noises coming from here. Let's try cranking it again.
Oh. Me always was like let me give it some gas. Spark plug. It wants to start. You see that? And look at this. There we go. Can't believe it runs. And it dies. It died. So if I let go, that's when it'll die. All this does is push the cable back a bit. There we go.
We're gonna do a test ride of this bike. Noise is gone once you start moving. First time ever on the mean streets here. Good speed. Oh, not enter. Oh my God. Suspension in the front needs some work. Oh, my front brakes just stopped working. All right, glad I found that. Let's see what this bad boy can do. 15 miles an hour, 25, 35, 40. What is happening? It's not moving. Oh man, that was weird. That was a little bit odd. So it's a very odd thing. I wonder what is happening. I bet it's one of the needles that's still dirty. It just died. Oh shit. How did it just die? God damn it. All right. You see that? The carburetor is completely loose. And here begins the ride of shame. Okay. I'll just be going downhill over here. Yeah, that was it worked fine until the carburetor got loose. All right, I'll see you guys at home.